falling feelings and fakes. And they leave with no second guessing, God, we killing our race. That's the enemy plan, but the enemy fake. If this is the way your life was, then I'm tired of this game. Played it so many times, I made a glitch in my brain. But it went from the bad to good, that's the difference of change. I think about it. I'm just trying to do it in my life, don't get by. I know everybody else trying to get by. You know what I'm saying? That's all we trying to do now. I thank y'all still for coming out here today, though. You know, for every good thing, like I said. But black on black crime, no kind of solution, though, you know what I'm saying? Boss man, don't get kept in jail, you know what I'm saying? So we just trying to get it right, y'all. Right, that's why we trying to get by, though, you know what I'm saying? Time of life, time to change. You too.
Peers, where's the love? Silly stereotypes which stab at my self-esteem, trying to submerge me in the strong currents of the Atlantic. When my parents would go to parent-teacher meetings, I would panic, because when you heard my heavy father's heavy Haitian accent, how do you do, Mrs. Johnson? That meant that I'd be the joke of the class the next day in school. Boat people, refugee, just to name a few, what was I supposed to do? So I crawl back in my shell, all the while still in denial of all of the rich history that Haiti had to offer to the world. It wasn't until I moved to Miami and I was already a young man in my teens, that's when I found out that Haiti was the first independent black republic in the world.
Amen.
In the Antilles, we were considered the pearl. So I started to research, document, archive, historical events and facts that may have fell through the cracks. No longer will I...
44 Magnum, Tech 9, Uzi, 16 plus 22. If you don't know your addition, I suggest you to stay in school. But don't be confused. We abuse and let loose because of rap. Eminem told me always stay strapped. That's why they protect themselves. Put the guns down, let your souls be free. Rest in peace to the dead homies.
Awesome, awesome.
More sponsorships, we need more collaborations, and we need more summer camps to keep our children engaged, because the high school students this summer will be taking coding. They'll be learning how to do Adobe. They'll be producing collateral for different companies so they can have a real experience learning to earn. So that's my thing. There's a lot going on, but we need more.
Anyone wants to chime in on that?
Program. You want to talk about your mentorship? It's
about safe places for summer.
Again, yes. So what are some successful community-based programs that you are involved in that provides a safe space for the youth in lieu of staying home?
Yes, as it was aforementioned, the New Game Movement Mentorship Program, ages 7 to 17. We provide mentorship for
us together on and understand that. So if you're coming from a wiser generation where technology was at its basic, its foundation, and I'm in the 21st century where it's practically here, up and running, come together and find, okay, we don't probably have to use social media for that. We could probably use it for something else and come to amends with something, but we cannot find a solution if your stance is it's all bad and my stance is that's all I know. We have to come together on that. We're never going to fix this problem. We're always going to have panelists about this problem, and this isn't a problem. The problem is the things that come after it, like killing in the streets, not being able to communicate with my mother who was born in 1960 and I'm born in 1996. That's the problem. because you have information that you need to give me, and I have information that I need to give you. Right. So we cannot help each other if we're going to keep bashing each other or bumping heads.
Social skills. So social skills outside of social media, that begins at home. That's the bottom line. You know, you have to have family time. You know, time to shut the television off, and it's time for us to talk as a family. I believe a lot of the times what the problem is, and I respect you, Elder, I do. Some generations is, be quiet, I'm going to talk. You know, and the children don't have anything to say. They can't voice their opinion. They can't tell you how they feel. So that's one reason why a lot of young people isolate themselves. They shut down. They don't want to communicate. Now they don't want to be social, because every time they say something, sometimes as elders, we jump all over them rather than adhering to what they're saying and try to get a better understanding of where they're coming from.
My brother Joey heard about me. Now, when you in the house and you come in with some earrings, how you doing, son? You know you're gonna have to take that off at the door, right? Not in my house. There's no girlfriend going on. You're not shacking, because I'm not showing you responsibility.
Absolutely.
If you can come. I had a young man who was interesting into my daughter. Greatly enough, he came to me and said, you know, Brother Patrick, I like your daughter. I said, that's a good start. I said, she's pretty, right? Yes, she is. I said, beautiful. I said, young man, let's have a conversation. Tell me what you want to do in life. You have a 5-year goal, or you're in school? What do you intend to be? You got a job. Who do you live with? My mom. Okay, that's good. You pay any bills? You help her out? No. So if you don't do none of the above, you don't work.
The model that you had, the same model, the same business plan. It's the same model. This one gets that one in the field, and in the field, some in the plan, but that. Same plan, because it's working. We just gonna switch. So back to the question, hinder. The best way for us to try to stop any hindering from the development is to have more of what is working. So we need more brothers. We need more brothers intervening. We need more mentors. We need more sisters coming together and not taking it out on the child because he looked just like that. You know what I'm saying. I'm glad I love mine. I did love him now, to the heart. So when I look at my son, I'll be like, oh, I love him, you know what? You know what, you sound just like him. Because I never stop loving him. Okay, so we as sisters, we got a job to do too. Lift them up.
Kids were being transferred to adult court. There were 1,300 kids in 1998 that were transferred to adult court. And we put something in place. Now, the number now is down to 120 per year. It's still too high. But what I wanted to mention to you is, since then, it struck me, when we put the program together, the juvenile sentencing advocacy program together, it struck me the background history of these kids. And when I looked at some of their files, my impression was, I can't believe this kid didn't kill somebody. Because what those kids have been put through as children, the physical abuse, the challenges in the community, sometimes the kids didn't have anybody to go to.